Hello and hi, welcome back to PSDESIRE. Today we are going to explore a really cool technique in Photoshop called dodge and burn with soft light blending and the help of selections. This technique will help you add model like lighting and sculpting to your photos, giving them a professional touch. To get started, first open up the portrait that you want to work on in Photoshop. Once you have done that, the first step is to add a new layer and fill it with 50% gray. You can do this by going to Edit menu and selecting Fill, then choose 50% gray and click OK. Next, rename this layer as Dodge and change its blending mode to Soft Light. You won't see any changes yet, but don't worry, we will use this 50% gray layer to dodge the model's face in just a bit. Moving on to the next step, right click on the dodge layer and select duplicate layer. Rename this duplicate layer to burn and click OK. You will notice that there is still no change in the original image. But here is where things get interesting. Go to channels tab and click on the selection icon. This will select the highlight areas in the image and give us a starting point for where we need to dodge. Now go back to the Layers tab, select the dodge layer and take a soft brush. Keep it in normal mode with opacity at 100% and change the flow to 10%. Now slowly paint on selected areas with white color to add lighting to the skin on the highlighted areas of the face. Now hold Alt or Option key and click on the layer visibility eye icon to see the layer. But remember, this is only the starting point. Next, select the background layer and go to channels again. But this time, click on the selection icon to make a selection for the non-highlight areas. Since we have already done this for the dodge layer, we need to inverse it to select the non-highlight areas for the burn layer. To do this, go to select, choose inverse. Now go back to the layers tab, select the burn layer. Take the soft brush and repeat the process. But this time, choose the black as the foreground color. When doing dodge, select the white color, and while doing burn, select the black color. Slowly paint on left shadows and right shadows, and paint on the eyes as well for smoky eyes. It's a good start, but we are not done yet. Select the dodge layer and take the white brush to paint on eyes. This will whiten the white areas and brighten the iris. Sculpt beneath the eyebrows to highlight this area and also the top portion of the mouth to give a 3D skin lighting effect. Whiten the teeth a little bit. Take your time with this step and do it patiently and slowly for the best results. And then sculpt the nose to give it a straight look. To give the nose a more defined look, we can sculpt it by drawing straight lines to make it look straight. Now select the burn layer, change the color to black and draw on the left and right sides of the nose to create an outline contour. This is a technique makeup artists use all the time and we are doing it in Photoshop. For this demonstration, I'm sculpting only the nose and eyes, and if you want, you can sculpt the cheekbones and pout. Whatever you wish. Take your time with this step and do it patiently and slowly for the best results. Now select both the layers and right click to select group from layers. After playing around and experimenting, you will finally achieve the desired dodge and burn effect. And then you can lower the opacity to reduce the intensity of the dodge and burn effect. In this case, I will keep it at 75%. And there you have it. Your photo is now beautifully lit and sculpted, giving it a professional and polished look. So, go ahead and try it out this technique after retouching or skin smoothing and see how it transforms your photos. Check out some of the samples which I used this technique for dodge and burn. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful and learned something new. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and consider sharing it with your friends or on social media. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any future tutorials or updates. Thanks again for tuning in. I will see you in the next video. Take care.